Canada Day marks free agent frenzy in the National Hockey League, and arguably the largest fish in the free agent pool lands with the Edmonton Oilers, Milan Lucic. Happy Canada Day to you, sir. Welcome to Edmonton. Milan Lucic, the Edmonton Oiler, what does that sound like to you, and what does that mean to you now?
It sounds fresh, but it sounds exciting. It feels right. Everyone knows I was here on Tuesday taking a tour of the new rink and talking to the coaches and all the management, and it's a team that has such great history, and you know, being a lover of hockey that I am, you know, being able to wear a jersey like this that some of the greats that have worn this jersey is such a special feeling, and to be able to. To be able to come here and play in front of the fans that they have here in Edmonton is something also special, and I hope that, you know, I don't disappoint them and I don't let them down, and I hope that we can get back to being a championship caliber team.
A lot of people excited that you joined the Oilers, and it's fitting that we're in front of this new arena. Is that something that really stood out to you, and what really, you know, caught your eye with this rink? Because a lot of people are talking about it right now, and you bring it up a lot in the interviews you've done today since signing.
Yeah, it truly is unbelievable what Mr. Cates is doing here for the city of Edmonton, and this arena that he's built is in my mind not only the best arena in hockey, it's the best arena in the world, and how he's transforming the city of Edmonton for Oilers fans and the people here is truly unbelievable, and that's something that played into my decision as well, and his commitment to this city and to this franchise and to the players and winning, which, you know, for me is really important, is that winning aspect. And you see the commitment from that starts from the top, from the ownership group. I think it'll trickle down all the way down to the players, and hopefully we can reward them with a Stanley Cup.
Milan, Edmonton's not Boston, it's not Vancouver where you're from, and it's not LA, but it is a city on the rise. What does this mean for your family? And just talking to your wife really quickly, she seemed genuinely excited about the possibility of coming to this city, which is actually a pretty young city.
Yeah, we're excited. We're excited to be a part of the transformation, as you see behind us.
Absolutely, and yes.
We're excited to be a part of that. And, you know, having the friends that I've had over the last, you know, 12 years that have grown up in Edmonton, and, you know, Johnny Boychuk and Andrew Ferentz being one of my best friends that I've had back in Boston. So I got to talk to them a lot about what it's like to raise a family here and what it was like for them being able to grow up in a place like Edmonton. So, you know, they gave us, they made us feel pretty good about our decision from a family standpoint. So, it feels more than right that I'm making a good decision here, and like I said, we just want to, from a hockey standpoint, we want to do as a team whatever we can to not let our fans down, because, you know, what they've been through the last 10 years, you know, they need, yep. It's about time we start heading into the right direction.
I'm glad you brought up the hockey standpoint, because focusing on the ice now, you mentioned Connor McDavid as well. You've played in the Pacific Division this last season. What's it going to take for this team to actually start making some tracks in this division and become a contender?
Well, obviously, with the big teams in this division, you got to be a tough team to play against, and it starts by giving it your all night in, night out, and being team tough, and obviously it starts from the top with Connor McDavid, who's already shown that he can lead a team and to anywhere that they want to go, but it's about everyone else stepping up their game and supporting him and playing that team toughness and doing whatever it takes to win. And fortunately for me, I've been a part of winning teams my whole career, and hopefully I can bring some of my experience here to Edmonton and get it going into the right direction.
Finally now, you just turned 28, you're a veteran in this league. How do you try to assimilate yourself into this organization and this team, especially after making a 7-year commitment?
Well, I you bring up 28. I feel like I'm
28.
Yeah, I feel like I'm 19 years old walking into the Bruins dressing room. So, I think there's lots to look forward to. I've knock on wood been healthy for most of my career. So I just gotta go out there and be me, and not trying to be someone else. Go out there and do the things that I'm good at doing, and hopefully, you know, hopefully I can bring my experiences that I've had, especially in the dressing room, and make it all work from there. So I'm excited to be able to have this fresh start and opportunity to contribute to a new team. And like I said, hopefully, you know, we'll go where we want to go, you know, within the 7 years that I'm here.
Absolutely. Hey, thanks for doing this. Look forward to seeing what you can do on the ice in the fall in that building right over there. Happy Canada Day.
Happy Canada Day.
Thanks, Milan.
Thank you.